Hi folks, my name is Mario Peach and today I want to show you a little bit about the TileWeb at home project, which is at tweb@home.tilespace.com. This is basically about different how-tos that I created for different operating systems. Everything started with an image for the Raspberry Pi, where I created a menu-driven script. There is some how-tos about using this script and some how-tos about how to create all the stuff for the Raspberry Pi. But today I want to show you a little bit more about the live CD that I created, which can be started directly from a bootable disk image. The image, you can download the image from a Dropbox page. It's about 40 megabytes in size, so this is really small. The distribution that I'm using is called Slitas, where you can see it here at the slitas.org. It's a very tiny and configurable Linux distribution which works very well to create a TileWeb instance. Okay, now let's create a new virtual machine. I call it TileWeb at home. It is a Linux distribution and based on Linux kernel 2.6, so VirtualBox has nice default settings. 256 megabyte should be enough, so always next. Then we have to create a hard disk. I use the QCow, the Q emulator, copy on write disk. There are some advantages which I may cover later. On the page you can see all the stuff also here. Okay, the name is the same, created. That's it for the creation. Then we have to adjust the storage, so we need the image. So let's have the image set to the ID controller, and there we have the hard disk. That's okay. And the most important thing is the network adapter, because we have to define a bridged adapter, otherwise it won't work out of the box. Okay, the rest can be default, or should be default, because all the settings inside with the image are done with these settings. Okay, that's it for the beginning. Let's say okay. Adjust the network. Now let's start the virtual machine. You can see it has a nice menu and created or started. It will take some time because the whole distribution runs in RAM, so it needs to copy the whole stuff into the RAM and execute it from there. I'll make a short pause and start afterwards again. Okay, I'm back with the configuration of the keyboard layout. Mine is a German keyboard. Okay, go on. Then it automatically starts or will start a graphical overview, and it also starts the TileWeb instance. So with HTOP I can get a list of all the running processes, and you can see it here. TileWeb is running as the TileWeb user, and it started an instance with the server with the IP address 10.0.0.37. Okay, can all be seen here. Now let's have a look. 10.0.0.37 port 8080. Okay, that's it. The instance runs, and we can get it to the wiki, or the default wiki can also be reached with the URL default here, so which basically does the same. So that's it for the first video. With the next one I will show you how to install this instance here to the hard disk, because at the moment everything is running in RAM. So if you change something and if you restart the machine, all your changes are lost. So we need to copy it to the hard disk. Okay, have fun.